Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Martin Eijer. I'm one of the founders of cloudprinter.com. And I'm from the Netherlands, Amsterdam. And I'd like to tell you a bit more today how we built a global business around APIs. To start with that, our aim is to bring the API mindset to the print world. The print world is kind of a legacy industry. They think in digital presses, they think in metals, they think about atoms, while our customers think in bits, in APIs, in e-commerce. So with our servers, we provide a solution to the print world and the e-commerce world to connect together. First, a bit of an introduction of the company. We are 4 years old. We are founded in 2015. We are located in Denmark, where we do our development. Our marketing and operations is done from the Netherlands, and our algorithms and daily adjustments of our routing is done in Ukraine. We claim to be the leading global print API provider. Well, we don't have much of competition yet, so we like to claim that position from day one, and we are privately owned. Before I start to talk about our global print API, I'd like to explain a bit or share with you how the printing industry is working as of today. Like I said at the beginning, the investment is still done in production. New finishing equipment, new cutting, more people, but not really in automation and IT. They rather invest 4 or 5 million at a large printing house in a huge offset press than $25,000 in workflow automation and those kind of things. On the moment that you call a printing house and you say, how much it costs if I print every week 10 books, 200 business cards, or whatever, they say, well, give me your email address and I will send the quotation. And that will take often 24 hours. And then when you finally decide to place an order at a print house, or even a web-to-print platform like the Vista Prints of this world, then it's still you still have the feeling your order disappears in a kind of black hole. You don't know when it's printed, when it's cut. You cannot anticipate on the delivery time. And on the moment you have quite a large files that you want to have printed by a local production house, you still need to upload it to their FTP, send it by email, use a web form, or retransfer, whatever. So basically, when we started with Cloud Printer, there was no way to integrate global print production into e-commerce platforms, procurement tools, etc. Then if we look to the e-commerce world, photo book providers, web-to-print companies, large publishers that are switching from keeping stock to print on demand, which means they print the book you order only on the moment you buy it. They have completely different needs. They want to automate the ordering to print houses. They want to use SDKs. They don't want to bundle order all their print volume anymore to one or two partners around the world, because going green is a very big and sensitive issue nowadays. You cannot print your books anymore in France, for an example, and then print, ship them across Europe to your consumers. You need to do it local. You need to save on carbon emissions. You need to offer shorter transit times, lower shipping costs, etc. So there was a complete mismatch between the print buyers, let's say the dot-com world, and the printing industry. So what a print buyer needs, let's say a company that provides personalized photo books online, or a company that is running a web shop where you can order your print. They need automation, they need integration, they need live quotation. They want to push a sample order to your platform and they want to know within milliseconds what the pricing will be. They want local printing and they want real-time production and shipping notifications. That's where we come in as Cloud Printer. We provide a global print API, which means our customers integrate only once to our API, and from that moment, they can route orders to 157 professional print houses around the world, which means lower shipping cost, shorter transit times, reducing carbon emissions. And no matter how we grow our print network, there's no need to adjust the integration. So which kind of customers do we serve? Large publishers, the Wileys, the Kluwers, the Elseviers of this world, well-known names in the print world, Web2Print and HelloPrint and VistaPrint, Flyer Alarm, those kind of companies are using our platform. How that looks like? On one side, we have the print buyers. They connect to our cloud platform via APIs. They request product and shipping pricing. For example, you post to our API, like, I want to have 3 books, each of them 100 pages, hardcover, and they need to be printed now. I want to have them tomorrow in Australia at that particular address. Our API will respond in less than 140 milliseconds with the price of the product, the shipping options, and the forecasted delivery dates. On the other side, we have our print partners, let's say the legacy industry. They manage in our platform their products and pricing, they receive orders, and we gave them the software tools to keep us updated about the production. Our service is what we called built with the mindset of API first. So we are not a web shop that opened our platform by an API. Now everything is built around internal APIs, which we made accessible to the public. And on top of those APIs, we have built a lot of applications that we offer. So for a print partner, for an example, there's an API where they can receive orders, like I just mentioned in the other one. But to make that more touchable, we have built certain applications on top of our API. An SDK for PHP, integrations with leading e-commerce platforms like WooCommerce, Shopify, Magento, Postman and for simulating an integration with us, HubSpot and Salesforce to track the order status of your order, Zapier, if I pronounce it right, I always do that wrong, to automate the integration or build, let's say, SEPs with applications we don't support yet. And on the production side, we work together with Enfocus Switch, which is a kind of workflow for large print houses where they can install an app in order to connect easily to our API without any custom development. So what we do on the moment you are integrated or you use our API, you build an integration with our platform, from that moment we use custom routing or automated routing, 2 different ways. Our algorithms look like, okay, that's the order you push in, that is the country of destination, which print partners do we have there, how were they performing over the last 90 days, we look to price, a lot of different parameters, and then we route it to the print partner. Customers can configure in our cloud platform their products, they can see the work in progress, a lot of different KPIs. But everything that we provide, let's say in our dashboard, is also accessible via our API. We often see that our customers don't use our dashboard or portal. They integrate it in Salesforce, Microsoft Business Analytics, etc. Like I just said, we use routing. We have a kind of algorithm to decide which print partner gets which print job. However, for large customers, think about a Boeing or an Elsevier, we have built dedicated routing because they want to influence, they want to know which print partner print their artwork. The reason then why they use our platform is they don't need to integrate with hundreds of print partners. They integrate once with our API, which is a matter of hours, and they are ready to go. A short impression of our print network. We have currently 157 professional large printing houses connected to our network. And it's our aim to increase that to around 300, 350 over the next year. Our business model, how do you make money with APIs? I mean, we don't sell artwork, we don't sell flyers, we don't sell brochures, we just route them. So what we do, we charge our customers a fee for each PDF they push into our network. We don't look to the commercial value. We don't look like, oh, okay, that order cost 100 euro of the print partner, so we will take a commission. No, we just charge for processing the PDF, and that's a fixed amount. Our customers are paying what the print partner charges us, no matter what is their volume. So it's quite a bit of disruptive, because no matter if you source one set of business cards a month to our network, or you order thousands of jobs a day, you always get the lowest price since we bundle our volume to our print partners. What's next? On our roadmap for the next 6 months, we are working on what we call cloud printer industry. That means we will white label our platform for print partners, web-to-print providers, e-commerce companies, to basically offer APIs to their customers for automated print sourcing. We have just launched Cloud Printer Express, which is a desktop tool, kind of virtual print driver that connects to our API, so you can push print orders directly from InDesign, Illustrator, etc. We will start to pre-flight PDF. To give you an idea, 50% of orders that are sent to a print house have serious, let's say, mistakes, fonts are missing, dimensions are wrong, and things like that. And that are things that we will check in the cloud and repair in the cloud before we process it to our printers. And the last thing is a connected app marketplace. It just went live a few days ago. We have seen over the years that many integrators build solutions for their particular customers to connect to our platform. And with our connected apps marketplace, they can basically sell that integration to all the Cloud Printer users around the world. That's what Cloud Printer is. I just wanted to give you a brief idea how you can build a business purely by API. We don't have a visual web shop. We have nothing on the website, just the API documentation, and that's it. Thank you.